when someone pisses you off, do you just ignore it or do you respond? Because I currently just responded and it kind of just pissed me off more. Anyway, hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. So today I thought it would be the perfect day because I have no work today. It's a Sunday. I'm just chilling. So I thought it'd be a perfect day to finally start decorating my apartment. So I'm gonna do a little series on this channel, and this is gonna be episode one of decorating my apartment, getting my apartment all cute and putting up decor, and just like doing the last final touches of everything that I've been meaning to do for months and I just haven't got around to. I just made myself a coffee. I told myself I wasn't gonna allow myself to have coffee today until I got ready to film this video. So I just made coffee and it's like 1:30 p.m. in the afternoon. So there's that. So I've been living in this apartment for I think almost 6 months now. Yeah, for literally almost 6 months now. And I have yet to properly furnish and like decorate this place. Or I guess it's pretty much furnished. It's just like not cute yet. I don't know why, I just kept putting it off. And I was like, I really want to film it. So I just kept putting it off even more. But here we are. I'm tired of sleeping on the floor. So today I want to start off with episode one being putting my bedroom together. Basically, this is what it looks like right now. I have nothing on the walls. My bed frame that I bought literally when I first moved in here has just been sitting on the floor for months. It was actually in its box for like 4 months and I finally took it out of the box and put it on the floor. And I just built my box spring like a month ago to get my bed off the floor. So yeah, I'm really ready to change it up in here. I just want to feel like I'm living in an apartment that I actually like and enjoy coming into. Like, I hate going into my bedroom, guys, because it's so undone and it bothers me. And I've heard that your environment is a product of your mind, what's currently going on in your mind and everything. And that's so true, because I feel like I've been so unsettled these past few months and I just haven't settled in physically and mentally, if that makes sense. Like, I've just been so unsettled, I've been so busy, but now I'm like, yeah, I'm just ready. And then here is what the rest of my apartment currently looks like. So basically there's just nothing on the walls whatsoever. I have like furniture in place. I still need to get a coffee table, which is funny because that's what I was struggling with at my last apartment as well. This is my office space and it's the only place to really put this, but I don't love my desk over there, so I don't know if I'm gonna change that up or what. Or maybe I'll just get some like prints to put on the wall over here to make it cuter. I also don't love my desk, but like I'm not getting a new desk anytime soon. But I do spend a lot of time over there, so I don't know. So episode one, like I said, is going to be redoing my bedroom and getting that all put together and everything. Episode two, I think I'm going to put prints on the walls. I'm going to, you know, get a coffee table. And then my kitchen for the most part is pretty much done. I mean, it's kind of messy right now, but there's not much like decorating you can really do to a kitchen. So yeah, I feel like, I don't know. We'll see if I do anything with that. Oh, there is one thing. Okay, my camera just ran out of space on the memory card and I forgot what I was saying. But yeah, kitchen, oh, up here. There's something I'm gonna do in here, so stay tuned for the future episodes. And then, you know, we just got my bike chilling over here. And then finally, my bathroom. This is my bathroom right now. Ignore the makeup and everything. It's pretty much decorated in here, but there's more I wanna do. Like, I found some prints online that I wanna put on this wall over here and over here just to like make it more me. But I do have, you know, some decor in here. Again, I'll like show all this cleaned up and stuff later. But yeah, I'm just really ready to make it my style in here, make it a really cute apartment, guys. Literally for my whole entire adult life of my 20s, I've been wanting to live somewhere that just really feels like me and feels like home and just feels comfortable and is cute and I'm like happy to come home to. I feel like I did have that once when I lived in Washington. I had my apartment decorated so cute and everything, but like now my style has completely changed. So I'm still like working on getting new pieces and stuff and like going through all the older stuff I had and deciding like what'll go now with like what I want and what I'm picturing in my head. But yeah, like all these pictures here, I don't even think I'm gonna put all of them up, but they're just all sitting here. And then this pile of stuff under here is just like stuff I'm selling on Mercari. So I need to find a place for that. So yeah, we're gonna work on getting the bed put together today. I probably will not get my bedroom fully completed today. Obviously, I still need to get like new decor, probably like a new lamp, some new pictures to put on the walls and, you know, all that fun stuff. But first things first, guys, I need to go to Sephora and Target. I ran out of some stuff that I really need to get. So we're gonna go do those errands first, and then when I get back, I'm gonna get in like comfier clothes and get my bed together. So welcome to episode one of decorating my little cute little one bedroom apartment here in Arizona. Okay, let's go to Target. Let's go to Sephora. Okay guys, sorry about the lighting. The sun's like out, but also there's clouds in the sky. So I just went to Sephora and I thought I'd show you guys what I got. I found everything I was looking for except one thing. I could not, for the life of me, find the Tarte setting spray. So I didn't get that, but I need to get that because I'm out of setting spray. So of course, first things first, I got the Better Than Sex mascara. This is the best mascara in the freaking world. Guys, I've tried so many different mascaras, and this is the one I keep going back to. I've tried like dupes for this. They're not the same. All the drugstore mascaras, they're not the same. So I keep going back to this one. I bit the bullet and I bought it again. And then I got two different eyeliners. I usually use eyeshadow as eyeliner, but like I wanna get back to using real eyeliner. So I just bought the Sephora brand brown shades because I have black, but I don't really wear black unless if I'm like going out like clubbing or like to a bar at night or something. So I got two different brown ones. I got the liquid eyeliner and then the regular eyeliner pencil, or whatever you call this kind of eyeliner. So yeah, I'm gonna try these out and see if I like them. Who's on the way out? 25/7 Lena style. And then these two products I'm super excited to try. So I don't know if you guys have heard, but people have been talking about this Ilia Super Serum Skin Tint. I'm kind of iffy on trying this because it has SPF in it, and I literally hate, guys, face products with sunscreen in it. I don't know why, I feel like it just changes the look of your makeup when there's sunscreen in it. And then I've noticed like all the products with sunscreen in it literally smells bad. It smells like sunscreen, and I hate smelling like I'm wearing sunscreen. But I live in Arizona, and I was like, you know what, maybe I should be putting sunscreen on my face. So I don't know, I'm gonna give this a shot. I've heard really good things about it, but yeah. And it has like niacinamide, squalane, hyaluronic acid, super good ingredients. But yeah, so we'll see. I've heard like, again, really good things about this. Apparently it makes your face look really good. So we'll try this out in another video. I'm gonna do a whole video on all these new makeup products I've been getting. I'm like literally obsessed with getting new makeup products. I love trying new makeup. I just love it, probably because I'm a girl and it's fun for me. And then finally, I got the Merit Complexion Stick. So when I got to the store, I thought this was gonna be something like completely different, but it's not. There's not a lot of shades to pick from, and I didn't really know how to pick a shade for this. So hopefully this works, but I've heard good things about this. It's the Perfecting Complexion Stick. Basically, you're supposed to be able to use this in place of foundation and concealer if you want like a super light coverage, and it's supposed to look really good, like you're not really wearing makeup. I don't know, so we're gonna try this out in another video. So yeah, I'm excited. I got the color Sand. I don't even know how to work it. Oh, and I feel like this looks like it'll match me, but I don't know. So yeah, we're gonna try all these products out, like I've said a million times, in another video. But that was my little Sephora haul. So yeah guys, I'm gonna go to Target now and get a couple things, and then I'm gonna go home and build my bed. Okay guys, I ended up going to Ulta as well. Shit all over my ground. To get the makeup that I couldn't find at Sephora. So this was the setting spray I was talking about. It's the Shape Tape setting spray. My friend recommended this, so hopefully it's good. I've been using the Urban Decay setting spray, the like 24-hour something, 48-hour, I don't know what it's called, but the Urban Decay one that's in like the black bottle, literally ever since I started using a setting spray, and I love it. It works amazing, but she said this one works better, so we'll see. I'm excited to try this. This is what it looks like. Sorry guys, my energy went like way down, but I promise I'll get it back up. I just need to like make a smoothie, get into comfy clothes, and then get to work, because I only have like 2 hours until the sun goes down, and I want to finish my bed before the sun goes down. Anyway, and then I also picked up this Tarte Lip Plump in the color White Peach. I also have it in the shade Poppy. I'm really excited to try this one actually, because it's like a really pretty pink shade, like a light pink shade. The other one I have is like a red shade. So yeah, okay, I'm gonna make a smoothie and then I'll see you guys. Okay guys, I put on comfy clothes and I got a smoothie. And I'm gonna be honest, all I wanna do right now is sit on this couch. Actually lay on this couch and take a fucking nap. I don't know why I'm so like exhausted, but I am. But I'm not gonna let myself do that. I'm gonna sip on this a little bit just to like revive me a little, and then I'm gonna get to work on my bed. I promise. This is a decorating video. We are gonna decorate in this video. But I really just wanna like lay in this sun, you know, and enjoy it, but I won't do that. Okay, I wish I like had something to talk about, but I don't. Ow. Guys, these little dinglies that hang down on my bracelets always get caught in my hair. Like, why do I wear these? Anyway, we're gonna call this Couch Talks with KK. With KK. You guys know like the dating, what do you even want to call it? Like the dating scene right now. For those of you who are dating and are single and are in your 20s and 30s as well, what do you guys think about dating multiple people at one time? Because I am someone who is loyal as fuck. Like, I am loyal to a fucking T. If I'm talking to you and I'm interested even in the slightest in you, like I want to continue talking and like getting to know you, I like 99.9% of the time will not be talking to someone else. Like, I don't know. I've done that once though, where I did really like someone. Then I ended up going on a date with someone else. But the only reason I did that is because this man hid that he had a kid for me for like a fucking over a week of us getting to know each other. And I like really liked him. And then I found that out and I was a little pissed and butthurt. So I ended up going on a date with someone else. But I feel like that's different because at first I wasn't talking to anyone else and I wasn't going to go on a date with anyone else. But I also found out that he was anyway, that's just a whole nother thing. But yeah, I just want to know your guys' thoughts because I'm kind of maybe seeing someone right now, not like really, but we're kind of talking and he is like open to dating other people. And to me, I'm just like, I don't know. I'm trying to be like mature about it and understand where the other person's coming from because like we're not official yet, obviously, and we're not like even close to that. But in my head, it's like if you're interested in someone and you like see qualities in them that you really like why even continue looking for someone else? Like, why not just like see it through with that person first and then go on to someone else? Because I feel like when you see multiple people at once, it's like a string of hurting people, if that makes sense. Like, okay, so this guy, in my head, I just know he's not the one, okay? So I already know, I've already written it off. But if he was to be the one, I feel like in the future, I would still, to that day, be butthurt about the fact that he was seeing other people while he was seeing me. Do you know what I mean? Like, I understand that people have to experience multiple people and date multiple people to know like what it is they want. But I feel like once you are in your, you know, older 20s, lower 30s, you kind of know what you want. I don't know what I'm saying, but I just am interested in what your guys' opinion is on that because I just think it's kind of wrong to date multiple people at once. And I know people do it, but it's like, am I wrong for thinking that way? I probably am. Maybe like it's a deep-rooted insecurity thing or something. I don't know, but like when I really like someone, I find it hard to even like entertain someone else. You know what I mean? It's like I have all my energy and focus on that person. Like, how could I even think about dating someone else and like exploring my options? I don't know. I just feel like I'm in the right. Please let me know your thoughts. One more thing I want to add. I also feel like a true gentleman, which is the type of man I want in my life, wouldn't be seeing multiple people at once, right? I don't know, guys. This dating world is a little fucked in the head. Okay, guys, we're in here and we're doing it. I feel like I could genuinely never be a vlogger because, like, how do people get good camera angles? Okay, so first, I'm going to move my mattress and all the stuff. Did I come? Is he killed? Don't gotta sleep. Yeah, I'm like, guys, this mattress is so heavy. Oh, fuck me. It's too heavy. we just hope that doesn't fall on me. Okay. So this is my box spring. I also need to move this out of the way. This little frame down here, you can kind of see, is part of my bed. Because I started putting it together and then I ran into so many problems. Basically, I couldn't do it because the legs of the bed were rusted, like where the screw goes in, so the screw wouldn't go in. So when my dad was here, he like re-tapped the screw thing for me. So now it works. So now I can put my bed together. But yeah, that was the whole thing. That's another reason this has taken me so long, is because I ran into that problem. So yeah, guys. Now, we put the bed together. Here we go. I feel like I need to focus. Okay, so where are we? I didn't do that yet. If anyone wants to come like do this for me, that'd be great. Okay, so we're at step 4. Attach the corner legs. I'm gonna turn music on now and enjoy myself, so wish me luck. Guys, I just got this Bose speaker. It's like a Bluetooth speaker. I've been needing a new one because I have a UE Boom, or I had one, and it sucks. So I got this instead, and guys, this is really freaking good. If you're looking for a new Bluetooth speaker that sounds good, has bass, is like waterproof, outdoor proof, and is pretty light, and again, sounds really good, then get this. I'll link this below, but yeah.
Battery 80%.
It's really good. Like an athlete. Big drip, what you call it? Big drip. Ice chain, built water. Ice. Game, I had to sub up.
Fucking turn.
Okay, guys, I did it. I put my bed together. It took longer than expected, to be honest, but I really like it. I think it's super cute. It's like perfect. But now we're gonna put the box spring on and the mattress and hope that everything lines up perfectly and everything's good and I did it right.
But yeah, I'm excited to finally sleep on a bed tonight. Like, hello. Let's just hope that it doesn't break on me while I'm sleeping in the middle of the night. I don't know. I think I might have did one part a little wrong. There's another piece that was kind of broken and I just didn't care enough to try to fix it. So that's like the middle leg here that kind of holds the whole middle together. That's the piece that isn't working right. So let's just hope for the best. I feel like with physics, it's fine. I don't know. Guys, I'm tired, but let's put this box spring on and see what happens. I just want to like make tacos for dinner and call it a night. Shit. Okay. Uh-oh, guys. This is kind of what I was hoping wouldn't happen, but it did happen. Can someone please explain to me why I didn't move the whole bed against the wall before putting the box spring and mattress on? Sometimes I don't think, but okay, this is what I didn't want to happen. Do you see this space here? Yeah, I don't love that, but whatever. Yeah, like I actually really don't like that at all. Dang. Oh well, it just is what it is. Okay, also now, is it normal? The back headboard's a little wobbly. I don't know if that's normal and if that's okay. I don't know. But we're leaving it, guys. At this point, I'm over it. I feel like that's normal. Yeah, that's normal.
Okay, guys, so it's the next day and here's my bed totally put together. The headboard's actually taller than it looks on video. For some reason, it looks really short on video. But yeah, guys, I really like it. I feel like once I get new sheets and pillows and stuff and like different bedding, it'll look a lot better because right now those pink pillows and these blue sheets that are under this blanket just aren't really cutting it. But yeah, that'll be in the next video. Again, stick around if you want to see how I fully decorate this place. You guys saw the before, the after is gonna be beautiful. I really just want to live in a place that I'm in love with. I'm gonna get new bedside lamps. I'm going to get a bunch of new decor for my nightstand and little side table here. I'm going to get, you know, new stuff for the walls and new sheets and all that type of fun stuff. If you guys want to see that video, make sure you're subscribed. I'm sure it will be out soon. I just need some time to be able to like go shopping and get all the stuff. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed and I will see you guys in my next video.